understand the register, what do you mean by register, and what is the register transfer language as well. What are the operations which is going to be held with the registers? So this is the important thing whenever we study about the register transfer language as well as the register transfer. So we studied yesterday about the register transfer language, and we told a language which is going to be used for working onto the register is basically known as the register transfer language. And whenever we talk about the operations within the register, we said in general life, we use the word operation, and whenever we do the operation within the register, then this is known as the micro operations. We discussed yesterday about that. So up to that, if anyone having any questions, you can ask me. So we discussed about this is the digital system. So what the digital system is, so we are saying anything which is going to be made by the registers is basically the digital system. Then after that, some of the micro operations discussed here, that common micro operations may be the shift, load, clear, increment, decrement, etc. So this is the, then after that we told you as the body can work only whenever the self is associated with the body. The body will not work whenever the self is not associated with the body. In the same style, you can say the body can work whenever the pulse is going to be generated inside the body in the association of the self. If the pulse is not going to be associated with the body, then in that situation, the self and body both does not exist. Means to say, the body is basically known as the dead body. In the same style, we told you the computer definition, whenever we talk about the computer definition, the computer is there whenever the registers are there, as well as the arithmetical logical unit is there. So arithmetical logical unit is basically known as the heart of the computer. And whatever the calculations we do within the register, that is always going to be occur through the help of the ALU. So ALU is associated with the registers, but ALU with register can function only whenever the clock pulse is going to be generated at there, whenever the clock cycle is going to be generated at there. If there is no clock cycle, if there is no clock pulse, then in that situations, computer is just a dead part. So computer is just a dead body, dead part. Okay. So in that situations, it is very necessary, just like the human body, the pulse is going to be required. In the same style, whenever we talk about the computer, the clock pulse is also required. So the computer will be in functioning mode whenever the clock pulse is there. If there is no clock pulse, if there is no clock pulse, then in that situations, then no computer, that is only the hardware. We cannot work onto that particular hardware. So clock pulse is one of the necessary thing whenever we want to perform any of the operations with the computer. Symbolic representation by using the RTL has been defined at here, that this is the whatever the operation is going to be occurred with the ALU with the registers. So these are the two registers taken at here, that is, that may be R1, R2, or that may be symbolically represented as in general form, that two registers are there where the operation is going to be occurred, that is R and R, and we are applying the operations with the help of the ALU. So this is the R and R, two registers are there, the operations is going to be applied at here. Whatever the outcome of this operation is coming, that is again going to be stored inside the another register. So the input is going to be come in the register, operations is going to be within the register, as well as finally the output is also going to be saved in the register. Later on in the third or fourth unit, we will break down this particular symbolic representation whenever we will study about the words addressing modes. So we said that this F, this is the function is there, and this function is basically shift, load, clear, increment, add, subtract, complement, and, or, XOR, etc. Lots of functions are there, which are basically known as the functions of the register, and these are basically known as the micro operations. Now we discussed about the organization of a digital system and told you that the set of registers and their functions, as well micro operation set and control signals combinedly defines a digital system. Then after that we discussed, we want to focus on that system's registers, data transformation in them, and the data transfers between them. So we discussed this earlier. Then after that, we discussed the definition of the register transfer language, and we told you it is a symbolic language. Basically, it gives the symbol for all the operations which is going to be occur with the registers, as well as all the components present with the computer. A convenient tool for describing the internal organization of the digital computer. It is a convenient tool by which we can describe the internal organization of the system. Can also be used to facilitate the design process of the digital system, and it is basically the facilitator by which you can facilitate the design process of the digital system. So registers are designated by capital letters. This is the general terminology which has been used by the Morris Menno, as well lot of persons who have done published the research paper or filed the had filed the patents. If we talk about them, then in their situations we are saying that the registers are designated by capital letters, since they define that registers are those which are going to be designated by the capital letters. But if you pass any of the patents, you file any of the patents, then in that situations, and if the world accepts it, then you can also redefine it via the, any other conventions also. This is the in general terminology that our study is based on UK or US. Till now, in that situations, we are defining these all things in the parameter of the English, in the term of the English characters or English alphabets. But if we want to publish any of the research paper in the future, we can publish the research paper in the future where we can take the input of Hindi. And if it is going to be accepted, if this paper is going to be accepted by the Patent Department of India, or as well Patent Department of UPSTO, that is the USA or UK, etc., then in that situations, even only one country that our India accepts the paper, then in that situations, we can redefine all the conventions again. So it is the possibility can be made by us by filing the patents in India. So registers are designated by capital letters, sometimes followed by numbers, as we already discussed you, that register A may be there, register R1, R2, R3, R4, up to and so on, Rn, and R13, Rn, etc. Any type of registers may be at there. Some of the registers having well-known names. Yes,
sir. Sir, these are the predefined registers, keywords. Sir, can we name any register?
Wahi maine kaha ki whenever you want to give your name, you have to file the patents in India. Such as if we talk here that I told you that right now we are following the education system provided by the US or UK. Okay, but we want to define our own system, then for it we have to file the patent in India, and we can redefine all the conventions. Since we are based onto the US or UK system, so the language is there, that is English. So the English conventions have been defined at here. But if we want to redefine these all things, then we have a requirement to file the patent in India. And if the patent accepted, then we can redefine all this in Hindi also, or Urdu also, or Japanese, whatever the conventions we want to take that.
Right, sir.
Okay. So we can try for it. There is no problem at all. If you will try, that is possibility. We will be there. That you can do that all. Redefine the structure. But can I for it? You or me? Itself not sufficient. We have to start from anywhere, and the lot of people of India, if do same thing, then in that situations this system can be redefined again, since this is the work of the hundred of years and lakhs of people from around the world. So if we want to redefine, the lakhs of people of India is going to be redefine this all thing. and have to file the patents, and the patents have to be accepted by the government of India. Is it okay? So such as if you purchase the laptop from Dubai. So Dubai having its own language, just like we have a language, our natural language, that is known as the Hindi. In the same style, Dubai having its own language. And if you see the keyboard of the laptop, in Dubai laptop, you will see that his language, that is Urdu or any other else, whatever Arabian Dubai, whatever the language they use, that is present onto the keyboard also. If you go in Russia and the Russian language is there, if you see the keyboard of the Russia, laptop keyboard on Russia, then you will see the English is there, but itself at each and every key, the Russian words, Russian characters are also mentioned at there. But this is the problem in India, that if we talk about the India, then in that situations we see only the keyboard in English is there. Hindi keyboard is not presented here. And that's the reason we all made up jada ho jayega. Lekin kehne ki ghar wale chillate hain ki bhai mere bete ka US mein job lag jaye. To gulami ki mentality mein hum fir jeena start kar dete hain aur apne desh ki language ko bhul jate hain. Mr. Asis.
Yes sir. Getting sir.
Getting na?
Sir.
जब तक हम उस गुलामी की मेंटेलिटी से बाहर नहीं निकलेंगे, सारे इंडियन नहीं निकलेंगे, ठीक है ना? तो चाइना हमारा सबसे बड़ा दुश्मन है, लेकिन यूएस सबसे बड़ा दुश्मन है या चाइना, ये देखने की जरूरत है। तो एक तो केवल चाइनीज सामान आपके घर में देके चला जाता है, दूसरा आपके बेटे को उठा के लालच दे के यूएस ले जाता है, यूके ले जाता है, ठीक है ना? तो आपका बेटा आपसे परमानेंटली दूर हो जाता है। इवन डेथ हो जाने पर भी माता पिता चले जाते हैं, डेथ हो जाने पर भी उसको वीजा नहीं मिलता और वो 6-6 साल सलवर नहीं आता है। ऐसे कई सारे केस इंडिया में देखने को मिल जाते हैं, ठीक है ना? तो असली में अगर देखा जाए तो दुश्मन
इंडिया में तो आसान भी नहीं है हिंदी को सर अप्लाई करना।
क्या बेटा क्या कह रहे हैं
सर? इंडिया में आसान भी तो नहीं है हिंदी को सर कीबोर्ड पे अप्लाई करना, क्योंकि सर यहाँ पे सर हिंदी से भी तो ज्यादा कई लैंग्वेज बोली जाती है।
नहीं, हिंदी इज द राष्ट्रभाषा है, ये बात की बात है कि आप उसको ना माने तो कोई इसका उसके तो कोई जवाब नहीं है ना भाई। आप हिंदी को राष्ट्रभाषा ना माने तो आप भी इस कैटेगरी में शामिल हो जाए कि हम हिंदी को राष्ट्रभाषा नहीं मानते देवनागरी लिपि को, ठीक है ना?
तो सर हिंदी को मानना चाहिए सभी को,
लेकिन सर बोली तो बहुत ज्यादा है ना, सब लोग नहीं बोलते सर इंडिया में, इस वजह से तो
दैट इज ऑन परसेप्शन। अभी आप कम चले जाएंगे आप किसी ऐसे स्पेस में, जैसे कि सपोज कर लेते हैं कि भाई गुजरात में चले जाइए, वहां गुजराती बोली जाती है, वो कहें गुजरात में जाने के बाद कि भाई हम किसी भी हाल में हिंदी नहीं बोलेंगे, हिंदी को तैयारी नहीं है, तो उसको परसेप्शन है, मत मानिए। कन्नड़ वाले कहें कि भाई हम कन्नड़ ही मानेंगे, नहीं मानेंगे हिंदी को, तो उसका कोई तरीका नहीं। बट राष्ट्रभाषा रीजनल लैंग्वेज इज हिंदी राइट
नाउ, रीजनल लैंग्वेज
कौन
नो सर, हिंदी नहीं, गुजराती तमिल,
हाँ तो कह सकते हैं ना, दैट इज द ह्यूमन परसेप्शन, बोलने की आजादी देश में है, हम कुछ भी बोल सकते हैं। हम कह रहे नहीं मानते हम हिंदी को,
हिंदी तो राष्ट्रभाषा है सर,
तो राष्ट्रभाषा है तो लाइए कीबोर्ड पर, ये जिम्मेदारी किसकी है? तो प्रॉब्लम कहाँ पर है
हमारी सर,
बड़ों की प्रॉब्लम। लेकिन सर आईटी इंडस्ट्री में तो हिंदी नहीं चलती है ना,
कैसे लाएंगे वो आप सोचिए ना,
क्योंकि आपने स्ट्रगल करना।
आईटी इंडस्ट्री में आपने इतने पेटेंट्स फाइल नहीं किए, क्यों नहीं फाइल किए? क्योंकि कुछ पेचाई जैसे लोग बनते हैं, आईआईटी से पढ़ाई करते हैं, देन आफ्टर दैट यूएस भाग जाते हैं और फिर उन्हीं के लिए सारा काम करते हैं, सारा पैसा यूएस लेके जाते हैं।
हैदराबाद बेंगलोर हर जगह पे अगर आईटी के लिए इंटरव्यू देने जाए तो हिंदी का कोई है ही नहीं, कुछ जो है जो इंग्लिश है, और यहाँ तक अगर तेलुगु है तो तेलुगु भी चलता है।
सो वी आर सेइंग कि आई एम आल्सो फॉल्ट, आई हैव आल्सो फॉल्ट हियर दैट मैंने भी हिंदी में पेटेंट फाइल नहीं की, इवन आप लोगों ने भी पेटेंट फाइल नहीं की, इवन हमारी जो जनरेशन जो रही पूर्वज उन्होंने भी हिंदी के पेटेंट्स फाइल नहीं की, तो हिंदी में वर्क ही नहीं हुआ। तो विचारों की भाषा, जब आप सोते हैं, उठते हैं, बैठते हैं, जागते हैं, आपके विचार किस में आते हैं, कौन सी भाषा में आते हैं? क्या अंग्रेजी में आते हैं
सर? हिंदी में,
हिंदी में आते हैं सर।
और बाहर जब एक्सप्रेशंस के लिए जाते हैं तो कौन सी भाषा में बात करते हैं?
इंग्लिश
सर, ऑब्वियसली इंग्लिश में,
इंग्लिश में करने की कोशिश करते हैं। तो विचारों की भाषा आपकी कुछ अलग है, रिप्रेजेंटेशन की भाषा आपकी कुछ अलग है, तो क्या परफेक्शन कभी आएगा?
नो।
तो इंग्लिश तो वैसे भी इनकम्प्लीट भाषा है। तो अब दिक्कत कहाँ पर है? आप उस भाषा को समझ लें और भाषा को जीने की कोशिश करें और भाषा में सारे पेटेंट फाइल करें, तो थिंक ओवर इट, मिलकर बहुत सारा काम किया जा सकता है, इसको बनता ही है। हाँ जी,
यस।
सो लास्ट टाइम आई आस्क अ क्वेश्चन, हु इज द ड्रीमर? So lot of students raised the hands, I am the dreamer, है ना? Lot of students said ना, I am the dreamer.
Yes sir.
So I will ask the questions again today. Okay, and you will got in WhatsApp. Okay.
Okay sir.
But yes, this sir. Is for dreamers only. ठीक है ना? So we can think over that. We are simply saying we can think over that. So whatever the convince right now we are following, that is UK and US based. But we can change the conventions by filing the more patents in India, and we can file the patents in Hindi. I know very well that in the start, the controller of examination of the patent may deny that Hindi language. But if a lot of people file that patents, then sometimes some will come. Yeah, if we fight on that. जैसे कि इफ यू सी लास्ट ईयर अप टू लास्ट ईयर, यानी आज से 18 महीने पहले तक सुप्रीम कोर्ट में कोई भी सुनवाई हिंदी में नहीं होती थी, यू नो?
नो सर, आई डोंट नो
सर। नो सर, सुप्रीम कोर्ट में सर इंग्लिश
है। सुप्रीम कोर्ट में आज से 18 महीने पहले तक, यानी पिछले 70 साल में सुप्रीम कोर्ट में जब आप जाते थे तो हिंदी में आप सुनवाई नहीं कर सकते थे। तो अगर सपोज आपको हिंदी आती है, आप हिंदी क्षेत्रीय भाषा से हैं, तो आप हिंदी से ही, सपोज यूपी से हैं आप या गुजरात, मतलब यूपी से हैं, बिहार से हैं, कहीं से भी हैं, उत्तराखंड से हैं, तो यहाँ की नेचुरल भाषा क्या है? हिंदी है। आप क्या लगता है कि यहाँ के लोगों के केस सुप्रीम कोर्ट में नहीं पहुंचते होंगे? पहुंचते ही होंगे। लेकिन जैसे ही आप सुप्रीम कोर्ट में एंट्री करते हैं तो कहते हैं अपना केस आप खुद लड़ सकते हैं, लेकिन जैसे ही आपने सुप्रीम कोर्ट में एंट्री किया तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट में आपको पता चलता था कि यहाँ आप इंग्लिश में बात कर सकते हैं, हिंदी में नहीं कर सकते, तो आप अपना केस नहीं लड़ सकते, आपको एक लॉयर करना कंपलसरी है। दे मेक अ लॉबी, लॉयर्स हैव मेक अ लॉबी इन द सुप्रीम कोर्ट। तो एक व्यक्ति यहाँ तो केस कभी लड़ नहीं पाता था, लड़ता था तो वकील को रखना पड़ता था, वकील कॉस्टली पड़ता था, तो कई बार वो खुद बिक जाता था, हालत खराब हो जाती थी, उसकी पूरा घर बिक जाता था। तो लास्ट 18 मंथ बिफोर सुप्रीम कोर्ट काफी चेंज हुआ और सुप्रीम कोर्ट में अब आप हिंदी में भी फाइट कर सकते हैं। बट 70 साल में ये डिसीजंस कोई गवर्नमेंट आकर ले पाई? कैन यू इमेजिन ऑन दैट? इन द सेम स्टाइल आज की डेट में जो पेटेंट्स है या ट्रेडमार्क है, तो ट्रेडमार्क में अभी तक हिंदी में रिप्लाई ऑन पेपर तो था कि उनके जो संविधान है उसमें लिखा था कि हिंदी में आप रिप्लाई सेंड कर सकते हैं, लेकिन रिप्लाई नहीं होते थे हिंदी में, सारे इंग्लिश में चलते थे। समवन चेंज द ट्रेंड एंड अगेन वो हिंदी में कुछ कुछ होने लगे हैं। इन द सेम स्टाइल अगर आप पेटेंट्स में जाएंगे तो आज सारा वहां पर इंग्लिश में है, बट यू कैन चेंज द ट्रेंड अगेन, मे बी पॉसिबल फॉर इट, यू हैव टू फाइट अप टू द 10 और 20 ईयर और 50 ईयर वट एवर, बट इफ समवन विल ट्राई देन समटाइम विल अकर, देन ऑल द थिंग विल बी, ऑल द पेटेंट्स विल बी अकर इन इंडिया इन हिंदी ऑल्सो। सो वी हैव अ रिक्वायरमेंट टू प्लान दैट ऑल एंड वी कैन चेंज द कन्वेंशंस एज पर द आवर नेचुरल लैंग्वेज, आइदर हिंदी और आइदर संस्कृत। हेलो,
यस सर,
यस
सर। तो जो रजिस्टर्स के जो हमने कन्वेंशंस लिए वो अभी हमने विदेशी लैंग्वेज को आधार मानकर लिए हैं, हम अपने भारत की लैंग्वेज को आधार मानकर भी ऐसा कर सकते हैं। इज इट ओके?
यस सर,
यस सर।
ठीक है, थोड़ा सा मैं इसको दोबारा डिस्कस कर रहा हूँ कि द रजिस्टर्स आर बेसिकली, जो अभी तक जो रिसर्च पेपर पब्लिश हुए हैं वर्ल्ड में, उनमें रजिस्टर्स के लिए कन्वेंशंस को कैपिटल लेटर को चुना गया। दिस इज द डिफरेंट मैटर कि इफ हम आगे फर्दर और भी मॉडिफिकेशंस करना चाहते हैं, हम किसी भी लैंग्वेज के पेटेंट्स, किसी भी लैंग्वेज के करेक्टर्स को लेकर पेटेंट्स को फाइल कर सकते हैं, एंड इफ इट एक्सेप्टेड बाय द वर्ल्ड वी कैन थिंक ओवर दैट। जैसे फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हेन एवर वी टॉक अबाउट द वर्ड कंप्यूटर, How many know the computer word? कब स्टार्ट हुआ? जो कंप्यूटर कंप्यूटर जो वर्ड है वो कब स्टार्ट हुआ? कैन एनीवन टेल मी? हु इज द फर्स्ट कंप्यूटर ऑफ इंडिया? मेन कंप्यूटर केम इन इंडिया, फर्स्ट कंप्यूटर ऑफ इंडिया, इंडिया इंडिया में, इंडिया में पहला कंप्यूटर वर्ल्ड का स्टार्ट हुआ
1989,
कोई बता सकता है?
1969 सर।
कल का जो डीएनए जो आया था टीवी पर, जी टीवी पर, आप उसको सुनिए। 1852 में एक रामनाथ नाम के एक बंदे को कंप्यूटर की उपाधि दी गई थी। 1852 अंग्रेजों ने दी थी उस उपाधि को, उस व्यक्ति के लिए दिया था 1852 में। उसने माउंट एवरेस्ट, जो उसके बाद नाम चेंज कर दिया गया था, माउंट एवरेस्ट की ऊंचाई कैलकुलेट करके बता दी थी उस व्यक्ति को 1852 में। कंप्यूटर की उपाधि 1852 में दे दी गई। तो पेटेंट यूएसए फाइल कर, पेटेंट यूएस अपना दावा करता है कि ये सारा कुछ हमने किया, जबकि यूएस खुद 1752 में बना हुआ कंट्री है। 1752 से पहले यूएस था ही नहीं अस्तित्व में, मतलब अस्तित्व में लैंड तो था लेकिन यूएस नाम नहीं था उसका।
सर यूएस में सर लोग तो सर इंडिया के काम करते हैं, काहे का यूएस है?
ये तुमने किसने कह दिया कि तुमसे यूएस में इंडिया के काम करते हैं?
बहुत सी फील्ड में कर रहे हैं ना सर, बहुत से में सर।
मजबूरी है आज।
हाँ वो पे अच्छा कर रहा है, बस इसलिए सर यहाँ से निकल निकल के
हमारी बात। व्हाटएवर आई टोल्ड यू जस्ट 2 मिनट बिफोर, थिंक ओवर दैट। आपके भाई बंधु कर रहे हैं ना वहां पर, मिस्टर शुभम?
यस सर।
आपका कोई ब्रदर है वहां पर जो काम कर रहा है यूएस के अंदर?
ना सर, नहीं सर, मेरे सर भैया हैं सर, वो तो गुड़गांव में हैं।
हाँ नहीं, अगर कोई कर रहे हैं तो उनसे पूछिए कि भाई आपको भारत ही आके रिलोकेट करना है, आप दोबारा भारत ही रहना है। कितने कितने केसेस में वो तैयार है भारत में रहने के लिए?
सर वो अब तो मुश्किल होगा, अगर कोई होगा वहां पे सेटल हो चुका तो मुश्किल ही आएगा सर।
आया पिया यहाँ का, ठीक है ना, चले गए यूएस।
जी सर, वही तो सर।
तो फिर क्या होगा,
पे स्केल अच्छा मिलेगा वहीं जाएगा ना बंदा।
जो नेचुरल लैंग्वेज है वो तो चेंज हो ही जाएगी, ठीक है। तो जैसे कि कहा कि अगर हम बात करते हैं तो कुछ स्पेसिफिक रजिस्टर्स के नेम भी दे दिए गए। तो जैसे कहा गया कि एक रजिस्टर होता है, दैट इज MAR, दैट रजिस्टर बेसिकली वर्क्स फॉर एड्रेस जनरेशन। तो मेमोरी एड्रेस रजिस्टर्स का नाम जो यहाँ पर दिया गया वो कहा गया MAR। PC एक रजिस्टर है, PC मीन्स प्रोग्राम काउंटर रजिस्टर। एंड इंस्ट्रक्शन रजिस्टर एक रजिस्टर बता दिया गया जिसमें इंस्ट्रक्शन के रिगार्डिंग वर्क होता है, दैट इज इंस्ट्रक्शन रजिस्टर। फिर एक AC नाम का रजिस्टर दिया गया, एक्यूमुलेटर रजिस्टर। तो जनरल केस में सम ऑफ द रजिस्टर्स आर स्पेसिफिक रजिस्टर्स एंड सम ऑफ द जनरल पर्पस रजिस्टर्स। वी विल स्टडी द रजिस्टर्स लेटर ऑन इन द एड्रेसिंग मोड चैप्टर। अगेन रजिस्टर्स एंड देयर कंटेंट्स कैन बी व्यूड एंड रिप्रेजेंटेड इन वेरियस वेज। सो फिर अगेन वी हैव टोल्ड यू दैट व्हेनेवर वी रिप्रेजेंट द रजिस्टर्स ऑन टू द बुकलेट, ऑन टू द रिप्रेजेंटेशन पार्ट, whenever we try to write the registers, we draw the registers. So there are some of the way by which the registers can be drawn onto the answer booklet. And we said that if we want to represent a register, we can represent a register via the rectangle symbol, and we can write there that is such as MAR, that is the memory address register. But we are saying this is the one of the way to represent the register. Some other ways are there by which we can the register. So registers may also be represented showing the bits of data, and the registers can further be represented here in such fashion also. So we can represent a register by using the rectangle symbol, and we can write there the register name, that is such as R1, IR, PC, PC, MAR, etc. We can also put the bit name. We can also put the bit onto the register, that 16-bit register is there. So we said that the start bit of the register is 0 and the last bit of the register is 15. So this register is 16-bit register. And simply we can put the name of the register. So another the representation is there that the 16-bit register is there. So we are representing the register by writing the name at here. That is the register RT is there, and the representing the number of bits, that is 0 to 15 is there. So this is the 16-bit register. The another way may be there, the third way may be there, that we can represent that this is the 8-bit register. So we are writing the 8-bit here, that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the 8-bit register represent here, and we can represent the name R at above or down below. Again, the fourth option to represent the register is there, that we can represent a register as a bit of a register, as a portion of a register, that we are saying that a register is there, that is PC, program counter register is there, and the two portion is there. This is the H and L. So these two portions are there. So the 8-bit is going to be taken by the PCL register, and the 8-bit, next 8-bit is going to be taken by the PCH register. So subfields are there. So a designation of a register can be given by a simply a register, or as well the portion of a register, as well a bit of a register. So copying the contents of one register to another is a register transfer. So whenever we talk about the register transfer, we are saying here that if the register R1 having some content, and if we want to transfer the data of register R1 into the R2, then in that situations always the copy of the register R1 will be transmitted to the register R2. But it never means the content of R1 is going to be changed. Suppose R1 register having the value 5, and if we do the R2 assign the value R1, then in that situations the register R1 itself contains the value 5, as well as the register R2 is also contain the value 5. So whenever we perform the register transfer, then in that situations the copy of the value is always transferred. The actual register will never empty. As generally, if you see the houses, suppose you have one house and you make the new house, if you transfer the content of the one house to another house, then another house will become empty. But in the real situations in the computer, that if you load your data from one variable to the another variable, from one register to the another register, then that in that situations the copy of the variable or copy of the register is going to be created. The actual content always present with the previous register or previous variable always. So we are saying here that copying the contents of the one register to another register, another is a register transfer. A register transfer is indicated as R2 assign the value of R1, R2 copy the value of R1, R2 load the value of R1. So the proper sentence in the computer organization is load. Whenever we talk about the programming languages, we can use the word assign or store. So we can use these words. But whenever we are saying here that this is the symbolic representation, that is R2 load the value of R1, then this symbol itself represents here, that is the assignment symbol. So R2 assign the value R1, R2 load the value of R1, R2 copy the value of R1, R2 store the value of R1. Anything we can use. But in the computer organization, the terminology used here that R2 load the value of R1. So in this case, the content of registers R1 are copied or loaded into the register R2 is there. A simultaneous transfer of all bits from the source R1 to the destination register R2 during one clock pulse. So whatever the transfer is going to be occur here, this always occur here whenever the clock pulse is going to be generated. If there is no clock pulse, no transfer is going to be occur at here. So we again said, note that this is a non-destructive process, means to say the register R1 content never be destructive one. So the content of R1 are not altered by copying or loading them to register R2 is there. That is the register transfer language is there. And this structure, this register transfer language is going to be followed by each and every programming language present in the world. since the this is the computer came first, then after the language came up. So a register transfer has been shown here in this particular, again, the syntax statement that R3 assigned the value of R5, that implies the digital system has the data lines from the source register R5 to destination register R3. So basically, they want to say that registers R3 is there, register R5 is there, R5 registers contains the content. But whenever it have to be remembered, whenever we talk about the registers having the size, such as R5 register is there, and suppose we said that R5 register is a register that is a 8-bit register. So register size is always the multiple of 8. So this is the 8-bit register, 16-bit register, then 32-bit register, 64-bit register. So this is the size. This have to be defined by the size of the register. So whenever we are taking that the 8-bit register is there and we want to transmit the content of register 8-bit into the another register R3 that is also of 8-bit register, then the transfer of the register content always occur via bit by bit. So we are seeing here that the content of the register R5 is always going to be transmitted to the register R3 via bit. So whenever we will transmit the content of the register R5 to register R3 bit by bit, then in that situation, first of all, 0th cell of the R5 content is going to be transmitted into the 0th cell of the R3. The first cell of the R5 transfer the content of the first cell of the register R3. In the same style, the 7th or 8th cell of the register R5 transfer the content of the 8th cell of the register to the 8th cell of the register R3 is there. Then in that situation, this all become possible whenever we use the some of the data lines to transfer the content bit by bit. So for transferring of the each and every bit from one register to another register, one data line is there. So we are saying here that if this data line is basically the wired circuit is there. So wire is there. So we are saying here that 8-bit register, if we want to transmit the data from 8-bit register to another 8-bit register, so eight wires are required from each and every cell of the register to each and every another cell of the another register. And these wired cell in star, these are the opened wire. You will see the computer which was present in the world in the 1950, etc. So you know very well that one time were there whenever the size of the computer was equivalent to the two big rooms where all the thing has been connected with the wires. So lot of open structure were there, but whenever the time become passes, that open structure will come in the form and the open structure will become the buses. So that in the market, there are the buses, that is the 8-bit buses there, 16-bit buses there, 64-bit buses there, like that. Whenever we said that 8-bit bus is there, then in that situation, the 8 wired bus is there. Whenever we said 16-bit bus is there, then in that situation, we said that this particular bus having the 16 wires within the one cable. So we are saying here a register transfer such as R3 assign the value of R1 or R3 load the value of register R5 implies that the digital system has the data lines from source register R5 to the destination register R3. So parallel load in the destination register, that is R3, is always occurred there, and control lines to perform the action. And whenever the clock pulse is going to be generated, whenever the pulse is going to be generated within the system, then data become transferred from one register, that is R5, to register R3 is there. Is it okay? So often actions need...
Yes, sir.
So often actions need to only occur if a certain condition is true. So this is similar to an if statement in a programming language. In digital system, this is often done via a control signal called a control function. If the signal is 1, the action takes place. This is represented as that P is a subset, or we can say P is a predicate, P is a condition, P is a control logic, P is a control logic as you write the programming language, such as you write the program that you said if P equals to 1, then this particular event occur, else this particular event occur. In the same style, we are saying P is a predicate here, P is a condition here, just like a programming language. So P is a condition. At the conditions P, that load the content of register R1 to register R2 is there. So this is the represented as P such that R2 load the content of R1, which means if P equals to 1, then load the contents of register R1 into the register R2 is there. That is the symbolic representation in the programming always occur in such a way that if P equals to 1, then R2 load the content of R1, R2 assign the content of R1, R2 copy the content of R1, R2 store the content of R1. Any conventions can be used at here. But in the programming, but in the computer organization, the most appropriate word is R2 load the content of R1. So implementing of control transfer. So we are saying that if P equals to 1 or P is a predicate, whenever this predicate occurs, R2 will load the content of R1, and the block diagram has been shown at here that R2 assign the content of R1 by using the AND data lines is there. How many wired circuit is there? Such as this R2 register or R1 register is the 8-bit register, then 8 wire circuit is there, or there has been a bus has been applied that having the
So you are not audible.
Sir, your voice is buffering.
So you are not audible. Clear.
Sir, your voice not.
Your voice should be not clear.
Sir, voice is not clear.
Sir, your voice is not clear, sir.
Issue with your internet, sir.
So connect your device with another network.
But you made it. Whenever the
sir, your voice is not audible.
Sir, आवाज नहीं आ रही है सही.
आज बहुत ज़्यादा lag कर रही है. Video भी lag.
Our data from the
sir, आवाज नहीं आ रही है. सर जी आवाज नहीं आ रही है.
शुभम था सर ये. कह रहा आवाज नहीं आ रही है जबकि मेरी तरफ से सारा कुछ ओके है.
अब आ रही है सर, अब सही आ रही है.
yes,
सर,
सर,
मैंने कुछ
यस सर
जी बोला.
नहीं बोलिए, कोई दिक्कत थोड़ी.
सर मैंने कुछ नहीं बोला.
ठीक है. सो नाउ आई एम ऑडिबल देयर.
यस सर.
यस
सर.
एनी क्वेश्चन एनीवन हैविंग टिल नाउ यू कैन आस्क मी. So we covered this slide yesterday. Okay. Now we will start from this slide, and I am giving the 5 minute break to all of you.
Thank you, sir.
After 5 minutes, we will reconnect. Okay.
Okay, sir.